love Italian food. I reckon we all do here. And Chef Stefano de Pieri is passionate about making Italian dishes simple and fresh. The restaurateur and author is renowned for serving up the rustic fare that he enjoyed as a child in Italy. And Stefano is also an award-winning winemaker, and he joins us now. Welcome to the show.
Thank you for all of you.
First of all, what are we making today?
We are making a risotto, a very simple one, with prosecco. Prosecco is an Italian sparkling variety grown now in Australia and beginning to grow legs, so
to speak.
And
you're telling me it's becoming more popular than French champagne.
Well, it is very popular worldwide. Even in France, it's beginning to surpass the consumption of French champagne because it's cheerful, easygoing. And in Italy, we start drinking it. Can I say this on TV? From 10:30 in the morning.
Oh, really?
Absolutely.
A little
anchovy, a little bruschettina, and a glass of prosecco. And off we go.
Okay. Now, so you've started going to use the onions.
Yes. When you make risotto, as you probably all know, you start with the onions, which I've already cooked. I've got some lovely stock going there.
With oil, and there's no butter in that.
But I know you, David, like a little butter. So to make you
for
happy,
risotto, yes.
There you go. Are you happy now?
Yeah, I am.
Good.
Actually, David's a very big fan of Italian food. It's the only food you cook at home, isn't that right, David?
Yes, it is.
Is there a specific recipe that you like to
cook? Well, mainly risottos.
Because risottos are simple and easy. In this case, as I said, you start with the onions. You don't even, you know, Aita, you don't even have to cook the onions because the rice is like a sponge.
Yeah,
it will absorb it. And initially, you stir in the rice with the onions so the rice gets toasted, as we say. Then we have to hurry up things a little bit here, otherwise we'll be all day. You get a nice prosecco, a sparkling wine, and you see, hear the sound of it, that lovely sizzle. Oh, look at that. Yeah, that's from the King Valley, which is an area settled by many Italians in Victoria. And so they brought the Prosecco with them.
Do you make this one?
Absolutely. Wow. And here it is. I make it with cellar masters, if I'm allowed to say that.
Well, you've said it.
Stefano.
Then, sorry, Sarah, yes.
Risotto can be quite tricky to make because there's a fine line between having it just perfect and a little bit gluggy. So what are your
Absolutely.
Tips to making
it? So keep it al dente, which means on the tooth. So taste as you go. Initially, you can, as I say, you can flood the risotto with quite a bit of stock.
Mm-hmm. Is this chicken stock?
That's chicken stock because it will absorb all this liquid. The rice is dry, it will absorb the liquid very, very quickly. And the trick with this prosecco risotto is to put a little chicken stock and a little bit of prosecco. Mm. A little bit you drink, maybe you can honor me with a little taste. Mm. So it makes cooking a little bit of fun. Cooking with wine is fun.
Mm. I better not.
Mm, it's lovely. Sarah.
That's what got me into this mess in the first place.
Pass one down. I'm not pregnant. You're pregnant.
Go for it.
Your health.
I don't know if you can see it, but it is very creamy. It's the starches are coming out by constantly stirring. So you have to stir the risotto constantly. You can't take your eyes off, really. But it's really quick. What does it take? 12 minutes to make one?
Yes.
Yes.
Well, I cook it much slower than you.
Ah, but you're not on TV.
We've got to hurry up.
But it's got to remain moist, hasn't it?
It will remain moist. Don't worry.
And no, I'm not worried.
What's in the stock?
Chicken stock. Chicken stock. And let me remind you that when you cook a risotto, if you don't put a sufficient amount of salt in the stock, the salt will never penetrate the rice. You can't have a blend stock and try to put the salt in because it will never get there. It will always stay externally and don't infiltrate the kernel of rice. So here we go.
Salt
the stock.
And some more prosecco.
And some more prosecco, and hypothetically some more in the mouth because it's about 6 or 7 in the evening or whatever, and you are enjoying cooking. Cooking should not be just a chore. Mm-hmm. Now, this lovely Italian-style rice called arborio is very versatile. As you can see, it's a very simple dish. But at the end of this, if you want, you can add asparagus, you can add some scallops, you can put some prawns, or you can serve the rice with a roast chicken, so you have a full meal in one. So you may have a chicken roasting in there, and then you serve it all together in a banquet style. Oh, yes, without being too formal.
So you bought the chicken and the prawns and the scallops?
No, I haven't today. Maybe you invite me back another time and I'll do it just for you.
Oh, fantastic.
How about that?
Well, we are going to keep cooking the risotto, cooking and stirring.
And
we're going to plate this up right after the break and have a taste test. You are watching Studio 10. Don't go anywhere. We are making risotto with Chef Stefano de Pieri. It smells amazing here in the studio, and he's also brought in the perfect Prosecco to pair with it, which we will try soon. With champagne, you were saying that Prosecco is actually getting more, I suppose, popular than champagne in some parts of France. Is Prosecco's obviously not the same, where you can only be kind of, the grapes can only be grown in the Prosecco region of
well, Italy. Like all Italian things, it's quite complicated, let me tell you. There is a law that says that it should only be grown in two distinctive areas. Okay. But then the law changes, you know, Italians are a bit elastic, and so the area that it's supposed to come from is extended a bit more and a bit more, all the way to Australia.
Oh, and wonderful.
So, yes,
you live in Mildura, don't you?
I live in Mildura.
The popular Italian town of Mildura.
Have you visited Mildura?
I've been to Mildura,
that's great.
And would you serve Prosecco with this?
I'd serve Prosecco with this. And as I was saying earlier on, this is a great little recipe because you can integrate anything you like towards the end. Asparagus, peas, a little bit of fried prawns, scallops, etc., etc., etc.
Could I do rice in a bag, though? And add that?
What is rice in a bag?
It's that fantastic.
We're close to you having to plate it up for us.
All right, all right.
The short answer is no.
Yes.
Stefano, can I ask, why has it not got a cork like champagne, but it's got this little beer top thing?
Because Prosecco doesn't take itself too seriously. Mm. It's a happy drink. It's an informal drink.
Yeah. Mm.
It is an affordable drink.
Yeah.
And my second question is, have you got a bottle opener?
Oh, look, there's one right there.
In front of your eyes, John.
No, I won't.
Goodness me. And it's drier too than champagne, isn't it?
Yeah. Okay.
I'll tell you.
Lovely.
I am prompted to finish up. IT here is a slave driver. Okay.
That's me.
Yeah, okay.
Yeah, a little bit dry. I'm still not quite
sure. Are you just drinking
the risotto will be probably a little bit of the. Oh, look at that.
Okay, it's great for your teeth. It gets all the little stuff out of you.
Yeah. Oh, so you're putting butter in there?
We come
to a critical point, Mr. Okay, some butter.
Oh, yeah.
Ooh.
In there.
That's quite a bit of butter.
Well, you want it creamy. And some Parmesan cheese. Now, you can't compromise on the cheese. It has to be a good Parmesan or Grana Padano. There you are. Jeez. The simplicity of Italian food relies on the ingredients being prima qualità.
Yeah, right? That's so true.
Yes, we are going to put it on the plate. This is what you do to make it creamy and integrate the butter, but don't do it in your face.
Wow. That is so good. If I attempted that in my kitchen, it would be a disaster.
I was going to say, everybody else saw that, right?
Here we go. It's probably a little bit al dente, but look at that.
Wow.
Beautiful. That's the idea. The rice, this rice is full of starches, and see how they form the creaminess.
Oh.
And the Prosecco cuts through it.
I love your passion.
Thank you. Wonderful. Thank you.
Table 7 risotto, please, Stefano. Table 7 risotto.
Yummy.
Table 7 risotto. Who is this guy's cream?
That too sometimes. Oh, thank you very much.
Table 9, 2 more risottos, Stefano. Table 9.
And you just have to go here and to order it. That's the most important thing. Keep me in business.
Yeah.
Right,
lovely.
Thank you.
It's really lovely.
Mind the flavour. Don't worry, it's a bit al dente.
Stefano, how come it's so much better than mine?
Yeah, full of compliments. Thank you very much.
It is a delicious risotto. And as a special treat for our studio audience, everyone is going home with some of Stefano's award-winning wine.